We are going to talk about the workday function in Excel. So let's enter today's date, and here's one of my little tricks. So you click on a cell and press Control semicolon, and it'll enter today's date automatically. So let's say that you started a new job today, and that you know that you need 100 workdays before you're able to get some holidays. So let's enter in this cell here, let's enter 100, because you want to calculate what the date's going to be from 100 workdays from this day forward. So what we're going to do is we're going to go into the cell, cell E. We'll make it a little bigger because I know the date's not going to fit. And we'll go up to the FX function and we're going to type in workday. And press enter. And so we'll select workday and we'll say OK. And so the start date is the date that we have entered here. And then we're going to go in the next cell, and we're going to select the 100 days that we know that we have to work. And the third cell here allows you to put if you know that there's any holidays coming up. And I don't believe the next 100 days that there is going to be any holiday, so I'm just going to leave that blank. And so I'm going to say OK. And it gives you the date in a serial number. So to get in a format that you like, let's select our date that we initially put in. Let's get our format painter. And let's move over the serial date, serial number of the date that was calculated. And so here we can see that 100 work days from today is going to be the 23rd of May this year. So that is the workday function.